Hello, BA Arts&Creations here. Today I'm going to be simplifying the life of Sirius Black, or Sirius Orion Black, his full name. So basically, you all know obviously who Sirius Black is, the godfather of Harry Potter, but his story, his life was really hard on him, especially after his best friend, James Potter, and his other friend, Lily Potter, husband and wife, their deaths. And that's how he was sent to Azkaban, and he was all worn out and stuff. But you can get more information on his life in Azkaban if you watch my video on Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban, simplified version, in my channel. But anyways, it begins with Sirius Black trying to be tamed by his mother. Or it's the other way. So his mother, Walburga Black, she would try to tame Sirius. She would try to have her way with Sirius, gets into the dark arts. But Sirius didn't have the same view as Walburga, his mother. So then, when it came the time to go to Hogwarts, he boarded the Hogwarts Express, and there he met James Potter, one of his best friends. And James Potter and Sirius Black became inseparable. They also met Remus Lupin, another best friend, and as much as I hate to say this, they created friends with Peter Pettigrew, the traitor he is. And then Sirius actually ended up being a Gryffindor, despite his whole family's longings, his whole family's wishes for Sirius to be a Slytherin. Gryffindor, again, it's the house for loyalty, bravery, and courage, basically. Maybe not that much of loyalty, but Hufflepuff, that house is completely on loyalty. Ravenclaw is for smarts and sharp brains and stuff. Really smart people. And Slytherin, my least favorite, but Slytherin is the house for cunningness and sneakiness, ambitions, I guess. But it's also the house for most dark people, and the Blacks were all dark. Well, maybe except Sirius and some other exceptions. So when his mother heard of Sirius being a Gryffindor instead of a Slytherin, she sent him a Howler. A Howler is a letter which basically screams at the person it's delivered to from the person who delivered it. And after it's done screaming, I guess, it just turns into ashes. So her Howler basically explained, Sirius Orion Black, you have disrespected the whole Black family and just insults him, I guess, yeah. Walburga just insults Sirius a lot. And also, she wipes Sirius Black off of the family tree, of the Black tree, the noble and most ancient house of Black. Yeah, there are many stories between the lines. The Potters are connected here, and the Longbottoms too. Maybe Malfoy's in here too. But yeah, Malfoy's connected. Lestranges are connected. Rosier, Crabbe and Goyle and stuff. But every single wizarding pure-blooded family, it's all connected to all in all the trees, in all the family trees. So as you see here, it starts with Sirius, Spinus Nigulus, Ursula Frint, and Elidora, and then it goes on to Sirius and Hesper Grimp. Maybe I'll call him Sirius a second, but then it all, if you see on the bottom, number 6, on the thing called Remove from Tree, Number 6 is Sirius. He ran away. He couldn't take all the beatings from his family. So he ran away. As you see here on the, if you can spot Bellatrix, Lestrange, Bellatrix Black, Lestrange, whatever, if you can spot Bellatrix, she was one of those, you know, spoiled people, spoiled daughters of Cygnus and Drula, but she believed in purity, blood purity. Every single Black in this Black family, they all believed in blood purity. Except Sirius and, I don't know, Finest Nebulous, probably? No, not Finest Nebulous, some other person. Number 2, Finest. Lots of them, some of the people in this family, they betrayed the Black line. Like Sirius, and like Alfred. Uncle Alfred, Sirius's Uncle Alfred, who is Walburga's, sibling brother, he gave galleons, sickles, and, you know, those money, gold, to his nephew, meaning Sirius, when Sirius ran away. Andromeda, she was the sister of Bellatrix. It's probably not on this list, I don't see it on the list, but Andromeda Black, or Andromeda Tonks, she married a Muggleborn, and this whole Black family hated Muggleborn, except the ones listed on the Remove from Tree list. But she married a Muggleborn and had a daughter, named Nymphadora Tonks. But anyways, when Sirius ran away, he went to his best mate, James Potter, as you might have guessed. And James's father and mother treated Sirius as their own son. They didn't care about his family, his surname, his family's rights that they believed in. They didn't care about that. They only saw their son's friend, their real son's friend, and accepted him as a surrogate son. They totally loved him like their own son. But so later on, when Sirius is all grown up, he was literally grown up. He had all the responsibility and stuff. When he heard that his best mate, James Potter, and James's wife, Lily, had a son, Harry Potter, and Sirius was named the godfather by Lily and James to Harry, he was elated. He was happy, and he's been taking care of Harry a lot, very goodly, very nicely. When Lily and James were still alive, he would come around and play and stuff, turn into Padfoot and he was like. But he also, even when he was in Azkaban, when he broke out just to see his son, his godson. He treated Harry as his own son. He's super mature now, back compared to his good old days of being a silly prankster. He cared about Harry a lot. And then came his, death week, I guess. In book 5, he dies. But Harry's been getting dreams, visions. Nightmares, I guess, but visions of Sirius Black being tortured by Voldemort in the Department of Mysteries. And now Harry doesn't know where Sirius is right now, so he assumes that the visions are real. It seems so real to him. He loved his godfather, obviously. It seems so real to him. He believed those visions, and said that. He said to his friends, Hermione Granger and Ron Weasley, Sirius is in danger. Voldemort's torturing him in the Department of Mysteries. Because he dreams about vision. He gets visions about Sirius. And then comes Severus Snape, the potions teacher, I guess. And he basically tells Sirius to stay at Number 12, Grimald's place, which is Sirius's home home place, not the Potter's area, way before the Potter's, when he was still with Walburga and his whole Black family, where the Blacks lived. And Snape suspected it was a trick. Not by Harry, but by Voldemort. Because Voldemort was connected to Harry's scar, and you'll learn more about that. I'm not going to say too much, but you're going to learn about that in book 7, book 6, book 8. Book 8. Maybe later on in books 5, book 6, or book 7. And it seems to have been in Cursed Child, but Snape tells Sirius basically to stay. Do not follow. But of course, Sirius can't stand being separated from his godson, and he goes after into the chamber, Department of Mysteries. Then introduces Bellatrix Black, Bellatrix Lestrange. Remember her? She was Sirius's, I guess, murderer. She did the stupefy spell on Sirius. The stunning spell, and Sirius got stunned and fell backwards, but that is a simple stunning spell, right? How would that, kill him? In the Department of Mysteries, there is a veil, a black, dark veil, which was called the Veil of Death. And the position that Sirius was in was in front of the Veil of Death, and Bellatrix's Bellatrix Lestrange's stunning spell was so powerful that it knocked Sirius into the Veil of Death. You can probably guess what happened. He just goes floating up, and then Sirius Black is dead. Of course, Harry can't believe that, and as you see the Remus Lupin there, he tries holding back Harry. He's like, I know it's sad, I lost him too, he's my best mate from when I was young, and still is, but you can't save him. And Harry's like, we can't save him, just grab out him, Remus. But Remus doesn't, he knows that Sirius is gone. But yeah, this whole backstory of Sirius Black, it's not in depth, it just explains that Sirius is a strong man. He, after the deaths of Lily and James, he was literally broken. His best mate, his one brother, left him. And he's not saying that it was James's fault. He was just broken. And then what made him more broken was that his best friend, former best friend, his brother, Peter Pettigrew, betrayed them. Betrayed all of the martyrs. All of Remus Lupin, James, Lily, Sirius, everyone. And he didn't even feel sorry. Okay, maybe he did feel sorry for it. But still, he was in league with Voldemort this whole time and didn't bother doing anything about it. He just went on with everything. Like, I don't know, a coward, I guess. And then that's when Sirius, okay, this happened before he died, obviously. This happened after Lily and James died. So Sirius got so angry, he was driven by anger. He went out. He lashed out at Peter Pettigrew. He found him. Peter was in hiding. He found Pettigrew, and then Sirius just, he tries, he's so driven by anger, he tries to kill Peter. But then Pettigrew, overcome by, devious, sudden courage, determination, comes up on him, and he shouts out, "You betrayed Lily and James, Sirius Black. You betrayed them. And it was all your fault they died." And Sirius stops. He's thinking, what in the world is Pettigrew doing? It wasn't my fault, it was his fault. I was nearly the cover-up. And Pettigrew doesn't care. He's super malicious, sadistic. He's all like, it was all your fault, Black. And then he secretly takes his, so Sirius Black's wand is out by this time. And Sirius didn't put his wand down yet. He just didn't cast a spell. He was just in shock. And then Peter took that chance to take out his wand and secretly blasted the bridge. I believe it was the London Bridge, on which they were not standing on, next to them. And 12 muggles, 12 people were dead, were murdered by Peter Pettigrew. But no one knew it was Peter. They all thought it was Black because his wand was out. Even the Aurors. So then Peter also, he's an animagus, remember? By his days as a young lad. He was an animagus to turn into a small rat. So basically, took his wand, put it behind him. No one could see this movement. He cut off his finger and turned into a rat and ran away. Cut off his finger for evidence for the Aurors, basically. And then Sirius was still having his wand out, and then that's when the Aurors appeared. Pop, 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 pop. They operated there in a pop, and they obviously thought it was Sirius, who killed the 12 muggles, who murdered them, who killed Peter Pettigrew, the traitor. But they didn't know he was the traitor. They thought Peter was a brave savior. Not savior, brave man. To try to defeat Black. And their suspicions were confirmed. Sirius Black was the traitor. In reality, who's the traitor? Peter, right? But yeah. That's what happens, and basically this is the end of the whole this video. And Sirius has been through a really tough life. Sad life. His mother, his whole family hated him, except maybe Tonks and stuff. Tonks, Andromeda, Ted, Finest Nicholas, Alfred. They didn't hate him, but the majority of Blacks hated him. And they called him a blood traitor. You know, he defeated the purpose of being a Black. He didn't want to be a Black. But that's the end of the tutorial. Hope you enjoyed. Okay, maybe not enjoyed, but hope you understood the backstory, the life of Sirius Black. Although it was a bit confusing.